welcome or welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'm going to flash back to when I went to the Florida Keys in January 2021 and discuss some of the photography locations I found during my trip. Some of these are more popular spots, but most of what I have on my list are more hidden gem, unique locations that you might not come across during your photography research. So I just hope that you're able to find a great spot to take photos while you're down there. I only have 10 on my list, but obviously there's thousands of beautiful places in the Keys to take photos. So this isn't a super comprehensive list. This is just based on my own experience. And if you have any of your own places or tips, go ahead and leave them in the comments. My list is going to start in the northern part of the Keys and work its way down to Key West, so it's just kind of going in order. A lot of these areas are going to be great for selfies, portraits, Instagram shots, or more artistic landscape, you know, fine art photography, I guess, if you will. It doesn't matter what kind of equipment you're shooting with or what kind of subject you like to shoot, no matter what, it's the Keys, it's beautiful, so you're gonna get some awesome shots. Here we go. Place number one is going to be the Hideout Restaurant, and this is where you should go if you want to take any kind of sunrise photos over the ocean. It is kind of hard to find a place to take sunrise photos in the Keys because there's a lot of, you know, private property, residential areas along the coast, and most of the state parks don't open until after sunrise. But luckily, I was able to get a tip to go to this restaurant, and it was a beautiful scene. The restaurant wasn't open yet, so we were able to park in the parking lot and take some photos of the vegetation that was next to the water. There are no trespassing signs there for like little docks, so, you know, make sure you don't trespass. You will otherwise be able to get beautiful shots and just, you know, respect the property owner and all of that. Place number two is gonna be John Pennekamp Coral Reef State Park. And this is an awesome place to go if you wanna do underwater photography, if you wanna go snorkeling or scuba diving. We did not do that when we were there. We just kind of walked around on the trails into some of the beaches. It's a really beautiful place. We were there like as soon as they opened. There were a lot of birds there, which my dad loved because he's a bird watcher. So yeah, if you want, you know, just some beachy Florida Keys photos, you can go there. There's a lot of palm trees, and there's also like these old cannons that are really cool looking if you want to take photos of those. So yeah, I suggest that place. All the state parks in the Keys are really beautiful, but they also do cost money to get into, just a few dollars. So keep that in mind as you plan your trip. The third place on my list is going to be really awesome if you love murals. I love a good mural, so I definitely kind of did some Googling before I went down there to find where I could maybe take some mural photos, and this is one of the best ones I found. It's a mural by Robert Wayland. He has different murals throughout the country, and they're called Whaling Walls, and they have different sea life, whales, manatees, rays, sharks, fish, etc., etc., and it's the entire building. Oh, I guess I didn't say the building, but it's on the Scuba Fun Dive Center in Key Largo. It is just, you know, a kind of a random building, but the entire thing, all four sides, are completely painted, and it's just beautiful. I didn't take any selfies here for some reason, but it would definitely be a good place for selfies or like an awesome Instagram shot. So make sure to check it out. It's just this unassuming building. It's on the main road, so you'll be able to see it just driving by. Number four. This one is probably the weirdest location on my list, and you're going to need a boat to get to it. So if you have a boat you can rent or anything like that, you'll be able to get out there into the water, and it is the toilet seat cut. it's funny because there's all these toilet seats on posts, and they're all painted, and they all have different themes and stuff, and it's just really cute. It's just a place where the boats can go through, and they won't hit, like, the reef underneath, and it's just this cool kind of hidden gem, a local touristy kind of spot. Anyway, it's really cute and fun, and if you have a boat, you should definitely go check it out. It's a good place to see birds too. There were a lot of birds in the area, so yeah. Okay, the fifth location on my list is going to be found at the Rain Barrel Village Shop, and it is a giant lobster. It's just this giant statue of a realistic lobster, and her name's Betsy, and it's just really a fun, cute place to grab a photo. We went before the store even opened, so there was no one else there to like photo bomb us, and we were able to get a few good photos of Betsy, and like the front of the store is really cute as well. This is a great place to grab some photos if you are headed down to Key West or are like in the middle of the Keys area. It's right on the edge of the main road, so you'll be able to spot it right away, and you have to stop. It's just what you expect to see in Florida Keys, I guess. It's awesome. Number six is Bahia Honda State Park, and I probably said that wrong. Bahia, I don't know. Anyway, pronunciations are not my strong suit, but the state park is a really popular place for swimming. There's two different beaches on either side of the island. It's a great place for photography with a lot of palm trees, white sand beaches, super clear water, and there's also a little like hike that you can take up to the old bridge, and there's really good views down into the water, so I definitely suggest stopping by. It does cost a little bit of money. Like I said, those Florida state parks do cost an entrance fee, but it's definitely worth it, especially if you spend some time there swimming and stuff. We didn't, but it's definitely a great place to stop by. Okay, next up on the list, number seven, is going to be in the National Key Deer Refuge and the Blue Hole. So the Blue Hole is a little pond that's up in the refuge, and we found out about it because we were doing research on where to find the best birds in the Florida Keys, and the Blue Hole popped up, so we ended up going up there. Well, my dad was more interested in the birds. I was more interested in the alligators because we did end up seeing two alligators in there. There's a short hiking trail that goes like partway around, and the alligators were like right there next to the viewing area, so we were able to get a really close view. But because of the way the viewing platform is, we were, you know, super safe. So we were close, and they were in the water, but, you know, they couldn't get us, I guess. So yeah, if you want to maybe spot alligators, that's a good place to check out if you're down in the Keys. And also if you want to see key deer. So the key deer are really tiny deer that are super endangered. There's only about 700 to 800 left in the wild, unfortunately, and they're super protected. But right here in the refuge, which I forgot to say, but it's on Big Pine Key, is one of the best places to see them. So if you go around, you might spot some. The place where we were able to see two of them was in this little residential area. Just a little bit down from the Blue Hole. We ended up driving through there and seeing a couple. Just make sure that you respect the property owners, don't trespass or park in anyone's driveway or on anyone's land. We stopped in the road a couple times when we saw the deer, but there was one point where a car drove by and like recorded us through the window. So I guess that was kind of weird. So just be careful, and, you know, respect everybody. There wasn't like anywhere saying you couldn't drive through there if you didn't live there, but we did see a couple deer, so that was really cool. And hopefully you'll see some as well. Remember to just keep your eye out and go the speed limit so you don't possibly injure or kill any. So yeah. Okay, number eight, we're now down in Key West. I have three different places in Key West I'm going to talk about. Yes, only three. There's a ton of places to take photos in Key West, and you can easily look that up. My areas are a mix of popular and maybe not as popular or well-known, so here we go. Number eight on my list is going to be the Ernest Hemingway House. Yeah, probably one of the top things to do in Key West, but I definitely suggest going there to take some photos if you love old architecture, or you love literature, or if you just love cats. He just happened to be right here. But yeah, if you love cats, I definitely suggest going to the Ernest Hemingway house. It does cost some money to get in there, but you'll see dozens of cats, and they are all descendants from Hemingway's cats, which I think is really cool and interesting. And they also all have an extra toe. So yeah, they all have an extra toe or two on each foot, because that was the kind of cat that Hemingway like collected, I guess. But yeah, so that's really cool. The house is beautiful and the garden area is also really pretty. Okay, number 9 on the list is going to be another mural by Robert Wayland, and it's going to be found down by the Waterfront Brewery, and it's another all-around encompassing painting of ocean animals, and it's just another gorgeous spot to take some photos in Key West. And then just a short walk from that mural, you're going to find another awesome mural on the Cuban Coffee Queen. So that's a little coffee shop, and on one of their buildings there is the postcard of Key West mural, and it's a great place for a selfie or an Instagram shot or what have you, and it's just really cute and beautiful. Okay, those are my 10 places to take photos in the Florida Keys. Like I said, it wasn't super comprehensive or anything. Leave your own suggestions in the comments or a link to your photos so I can see them. I hope you enjoyed this video. Go ahead and give it a like, subscribe if you want some more photography and travel videos. My next video I'm going to make is where to do drone photography in the Keys. So go ahead and check that out in the future, or if it is the future already, then it's already online and you can watch it. I don't know what I'm saying anymore. Thanks for watching. Okay, bye.